In one of these earlier videos today, I said that you ought to have prayed in a manner that your flight would not have been on in the winter or on the Sabbath day. But I said I would expand upon that. But of course, the manner I was referring to would be in a manner of obedience to the testimony of His word. In Proverbs 28:9, He tells us that if our prayers are an abomination to Him, if we turn His ears, our dual ears, from listening to His Torah, just abomination to Him. You either believe that or you don't. So listening to it is doing. It's not hearing with your ears. It's the doers of His Torah. I talked about that in a recent video as well. So, of course, when we pray, even Yeshua taught us, His only begotten Son, taught us how to pray. Pray that His Father, His desire would be done on earth as it is in His dual heavens. And, of course, that we wouldn't be led into the testing, which is a big part of this. What to pray that we're not being led into testing means that we're going to do our part, which is to do that which would cause Him to not lead us in the testing, the temptations, which to cause Him to not give us over to demons, to spirits that teach us to live in rebellion to Him, but by His, be guided by His Spirit. And that's, of course, obedience to Him, obedience to the testimony of His word, with the earnest desire, the earnest and true desire, complete desire, to become one with Him, as He is, the image of Elohim, without blemish. You shall therefore be without blemish, as your Father is in the dual heavens, is without blemish. In case you don't know, His only begotten Son spoke those words as well as my predecessor Moses, and I've spoken them throughout these videos. It's just reality. We're commanded. It's not a suggestion. Yeshua said, if you want to be perfect, well, we're commanded to be perfect. So He says, if you want to obey our Maker and be perfect, go and sell that which you have and give it to one that's poor. It's not complicated. But you ought to have prayed in a manner that your flight would not have been in the winter on the Sabbath day, because tonight at 3:02 a.m., the beginning of winter at Yahweh's house. And the significance of that, tying into day number 11-2 of this month, day number 302 and such, a lot of stuff is amazing. But beginning of winter on the Sabbath day. And it's just not any Sabbath. It's the 256th Sabbath since He started me to number them. Strong's number 256 is Ahab. In case you don't know, that's who Elijah went to confront. But tomorrow night, the Star of Bethlehem, that's amazing, that conjunction, the Great Conjunction. But all this stuff is amazing. But tomorrow night, with that Great Conjunction, the 400th night of the Abraham lamp at Sukkoth, wow, the Genesis chapter 15 prophecy, the iniquity of the Amorites, and of course you have a different 400 coming up shortly behind that too, that's pretty significant. But it's night number 319 tomorrow night of the dual double Abraham lamps. And I didn't explain it that well in yesterday's videos. I have in other videos, but yesterday's video, I guess. But the dual double light window, that's called the dual double light, that's one cubit. That's dual double light is the word that's typically translated noon. Noon. So that puts some significance on things too. But 319, parallel in Abraham's 318 refined servants in Abraham that went and smote the four kings that had smitten the five kings and taken his nephew Lot captive, and different things. But day number, because tomorrow's day number 315, 11:15, the Sabbath, is day number 315 according to our Maker's restored calendar. Well, 4 days later, the most blasphemous day of the year on Satan's calendar is day number 319. So that's significant of the year. It's on 11:19 on our Maker's restored calendar. But Yeshua's instructions, of course, to pray in a manner that our prayers would be heard and our flight would not be on the Sabbath or in the winter, they accompany the instructions for the abomination the abomination of desolation. When the abomination of desolation is uncovered, do not even go back into your houses, and just do not even return home for your clothes. Go, flee. That's just reality, because it's going to come to that. Now, when He showed His anointed the abomination of desolation, I fled, but He let me go back into my houses because He gave me time. But you're not going to have, as a matter of fact, because of the passport situation with the wife who fled in the wilderness. Her daughter had the passport because her father is from overseas, so she had a passport. But the elder wife had let her passport expire, and it took some time to get a passport, and He slowed that process and let us liquidate some stuff. To go to Greece, so He could bring me back from Greece. But it accompanies the instructions to pray in a manner that your flight is not in the winter or on the Sabbath day. come with the fleeing from the abomination of desolation. But tomorrow, some cool things. Uriah and Zechariah, the faithful witness twins, will be in the womb for 336 days. It's the 359th day for Meher and Rachel, but 336 days. They were, our ancestors were at Horeb, 356 days, encompassing when they got there on 315 until this cloud picked up on 220, but encompassing 336 days. But tomorrow, 336th day that the faithful witness twins, Uriah and Zechariah, have been in the womb. You subtract 600 days for the count of the flood, and you get to 315, the Horeb waypoint, the day that he brought me up out from prison last year in the 6,000th year of the ram's horn release of debts. Wow. So out from prison plus 600 days is tomorrow. That's amazing, as it was in the days of Noah. His Elijah prophecy for those three tiers of 50 and one men, the 24th day of the ninth month plus 50 and one days is tomorrow. The 24th day of the ninth month is the shaking of the dual heavens and the earth waypoint. Of course, 3 days from tomorrow will be the second stroke of the dove. That's amazing in itself, because that's, of course, Christmas Eve. I hate to use the word Christmas, but you can understand the X, like X marks the spot. Xmas Eve, the massive, from the mother horror, the massive. They're make-believe images of our Maker's only begotten Son, and all the make-believe images of his only begotten Son that her daughters taught their flocks to follow. But that's amazing. But of course, plus 4 days is the X marks the spot, Christmas. Oh, plus 3 and 4, and those 8 tiers are for 3 and 4 of iniquities, of your iniquities in Amos, that he's going to smite you. And of course, the last 2 are referring to Judah and Israel, but they're all referring to conditions of Judah and Israel, because he's going to give the scattered descendants of Israel. Judah refers to Israel as well. He just separates it because of putting emphasis on the seed of David, which of course, it came from that Ephraimite, Jesse, because it's all prophecy, and it's quite amazing. It's all quite amazing, but there are so many things. Sabbath 256 tomorrow for Ahab is big, but there's just a lot of stuff. But the basic is pray in a manner that your flight is not on the Sabbath day or in the winter. First day of winter tomorrow is on the Sabbath day. That's pretty basic. Happened 3 years ago, too. It's kind of amazing on Jehovah's Restored calendar. I thought that was it, but no. 3 years is 1,080 days, which has significance as well. But no, he continued to shorten the days, because at that time, 3 years ago, he did begin to bring forth the Emmanuel, Man-Child, Meher, Shalom, Kushbaz. Because we're over 3 years into this, ever since the Virgin and his dual heaven sign on the 30th day of the 7th month on his restored calendar, which was the 23rd of September, 923, on his servant Satan's calendar. But you ought to have prayed in a manner that your flight wouldn't have been in the winter or on the Sabbath day. Whether he lets us loose tomorrow or not, tomorrow is marked in a big way that the Sabbath is here, the winter is here, noon is marked tomorrow, tomorrow night is marked, 3 days later is marked, 4 days later is marked for 3 and 4, and of course, 10 days later is marked too for the third dove, and 9 days later is marked for the 40th day of me lying on my right side. There's some big marks he's put on these coming 10 days at different places through them. Like I said, you ought to have prayed that you're in a manner that your flight would have not been in the winter or on the Sabbath day. You ought to have prayed in a manner that your prayers weren't an abomination to him.